If you're searching for a dream home but need help choosing the right property or the right location, you've come to the right channel. Hello and welcome. You're watching Property Hotline with me, Kavita Krishnan. This is Magic Bricks Now. Today, we are focusing on buying, selling and investing in property across the country. Get in touch. If you have a question, our expert for the day is Jayashree Kurup. Jayashree is the head of content and research at magicbricks.com. Jayashree, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Kavita.
Jayashree, our first caller for the day has dialed in. Prashant Thakkar has called us from Mumbai. Prashant, what's your question? How can we help you?
Yeah, thank you for connecting me here. My question is that I'm looking for a 1 BHK in Mulund for the self-consumption purpose, and my budget is roughly 1 to 1.1 crore.
Okay.
So I want to know that is it a good time to buy or should I wait for some time? Because we see that some correction is there. So I want to know if I'm right or I'm wrong on that area.
Okay, you're hearing that there is a possibility of prices correcting in Mumbai and you want to know whether you should wait before you buy a property in Mulund. Well, as far as we know, the data that we're looking at, Prashant, prices are not really correcting. What is your take on that, Jayashree?
I think more or less the prices have corrected themselves and I don't see it coming down significantly after this. We will, over the last 2 years, we've seen a fairly flat market. And in Mulund West and East, if I look at it, I don't see the values correcting themselves. I think, you know, actually, Kavita, you'll never know that a market has bottomed out till it starts rising, right? But I would say that a calculated guess is that the markets have more or less corrected themselves and we don't see any trigger for them going further down. We have seen that after about 14, 15 quarters of drop, we have seen a small correction in values across the country. So we make a calculated guess that the markets have corrected themselves.
Okay. Also, what would you say about the budget that Prashant is working with? He's looking at a budget of 1 to 1.1 crore and he's looking to buy a flat for end use. Now, it is a 1 BHK, I believe, that he's looking to buy, at which within 14,000 rupees per square foot rate, I think he should get enough options in that budget, right?
Exactly. I think he should be able to get enough options. And if in Mulund Colony, for instance, if you look at a 1 BHK, and I'm quoting strict off the site, I see that he can get about 500 to 630 square foot apartment, a 1 BHK apartment, and that's available, that's listed on the site. You may be able to negotiate a little bit on listed prices because of the market conditions currently. In Mulund West and East, I think he should be able to get a slightly smaller 240 to 550 square feet apartment, which is available, and I think he should be able to manage in this budget.
Right. And before we move on very quickly, since you said markets seem to have bottomed out, which, like you said, is a calculated guess. Tell us this, how long do you think these prices will hold? Do you see, any spike in prices coming in soon?
I don't see a spike, Kavita. In fact, I don't see a spike for a long while. What I do see is a gradual rise. Now, when a market corrects itself, when it drops or rises, the chances of the property that you want remaining at the present value is not there. The market as a whole may either rise or drop. But if you are choosing a particular property, that property price may remain where it is or even go up, even if the rest of the market doesn't, because clearly you're choosing something that is useful to you. It is a good location. It's convenient and so on. So I think broadly, if the market has corrected itself, this is a good time for you to go out and search for the property that you want. There are plenty of options because the market has been slow. There are plenty of options, listings available. Go check out these properties. You don't need to be in a hurry that the prices are going to go up dramatically very soon. But I think this gives you a little window to go shop, check out, and then purchase your property. And I don't think you will be overpriced. It will be overpriced right now.
Right, Prashant. Good time to buy over there. Market is just about turning. And like Jayashree said, there is a lot of supply. You can actually pick and choose in this market. Not only that, you can also try your luck and negotiate on the list prices. For all you know, the developer might just give you a hefty discount in order to retain a buyer, right? Moving on now from Mumbai to Bengaluru, from where we have a viewer, Santosh, who's tweeted in a query. Now, Santosh says that he has booked a flat in Kolte Patil Raga in Hennur Main Road, Bengaluru. He wants to know what kind of growth he can expect in this location in the next few years. I don't know about the next few years, but Jayashree, Hennur Main Road is already seeing a lot of growth, right?
Yes, it has seen a lot of growth. This is one project that has been a little slow. They have had to shift their delivery dates, but it's expected to be ready by the end of this year. 2016 December is when they are expecting to hand over possession. And we did check with the developers themselves, and they are very confident that they will be able to give it in December. The Hennur Main Road has had already seen some correction, some rise, and I think North Bangalore, there is a lot of demand, there is a lot of supply, and it is an active market. So it's not, again, I would say that you're not going to see a meteoric rise in values in North Bangalore, but there should be a steady rise in values over the next 3-4 years.
Right, you can see steady growth in that market, and our chart, like you can see, is actually showing a 21% growth over a 2-year period. That is the meteoric rise that, Jayashree has been talking about. Jayashree, what would you say is steady growth? Okay, the last 1 year has actually seen 1% growth and the prices are kind of going down over there. What is steady growth, Jayashree? How much can we expect?
5-6% in today's market, I would say steady growth would be about 5-6%. It may not even reach the inflation index, because inflation we put at about 9-10%. I think a 5-6% is what you can expect in the next 2 years. After that, if the economy picks up, you can expect a 10-12% rise after that.
Right, all contingent on the economy picking up over there. You can expect 10% upwards if the economy picks up. Jairaj is on the line from Chennai. Jairaj, how can we help you? What's your question?
Hi, this is Jairaj. I'm looking for a 2 BHK near OMR region. So can you suggest me some of that good projects where I can find within a budget of around 40-50 lakhs?
40-50 lakh budget. OMR in Chennai is where he wants to buy a 2 BHK. What would you suggest, Jayashree?
I see a lot of options. There are places like Sholinganallur, along the OMR, there are plenty of places where you can get property within your budget. But when I look at your budget is a little small. So what I do find is these are small local developers that are building these apartments, and between Sholinganallur and Thoraipakkam, you can get about 750 to 850 square feet apartments. But because they're small local developers and not large national developers, what I would suggest is do your due diligence very carefully, check out all the approvals, and also check out whether they have the titles are clear, because these are important things, and you want to be able to actually live in comfort after that. And so do your due diligence very carefully.
Jayashree, one other thing that I wanted to ask you, you've given quite a laundry list of locations over there. You've mentioned Sholinganallur, Thoraipakkam, Perumbakkam, Siruseri, Kedambakkam, Sholinganallur again. Which area should he ideally be picking? Which location is the best? Because Jairaj is looking to invest, from what I understand. So which is the ideal market for investment?
It's like this, Kavita. Check out the properties. Check out which one suits you best in terms of, outflow, the location. The location is very important. If you're looking at investing, those areas which are well connected to the transport corridors, if the house is located very and it's easily accessible from the transport corridors, not much traffic jams in that place, those tend to do well. We have found a lot of demand for series. We've seen Sholinganallur a lot of demand. So I would say that actually, how do you estimate how the prices will go up? Those places which are most convenient to end users are the ones that will go up over a period of time. But also look at those properties which will give you a steady rental return while you are holding it for the leverage value to go up. So I would say look at convenience and look at the social infrastructure, good quality roads, hospitals, schools, ATMs and so on. These are the things that normally push up property values.
Right, those are key things that you should be looking at. In fact, I would say it is one of the key takeaways on our show that is coming in right at the beginning of our show. Like Jayashree said, when you are looking to invest in property, first rule of the game, buy property, invest in property that you would choose to live in. Do not invest in property that you cannot live in. Because if you can't live in, chances are nobody else is going to be able to live in that particular property. Second thing that you need to look out for are transport corridors. Is it possible to travel to and fro from that particular location? Third thing, look for good social infrastructure. There should be schools, there should be hospitals, there should be ATMs. The necessities of life should be around that particular home. And all of this combined should be able to give you steady rental returns while you wait for that property to appreciate. Moving on, next query comes in via Facebook. Prem Vasan has written in. Now, he says that he owns a 2BHK flat in Alaknanda and Kalkaji in Delhi. Now, he feels that the property in this area has reached its peak. He wants to sell it. He wants to reinvest the capital gains in Gurgaon or Mohali. Which areas or properties would you suggest, Jayashree, where he can invest? He's looking for good rental returns since he wishes to use the rent as income for his pension. So he is looking at Gurgaon over there, obviously IT-driven rental returns. What would you suggest?
First, let's pick up his Alaknanda property, which he wants to sell. Since he hasn't given me what the size is and whether it is from a DDA or another development, you can get a range between 50 lakh to 1 crore for that property, a 2BHK property. So let's play with that amount of money that he would get when he sells his Alaknanda property. The second thing is that if you're looking at Gurgaon, I think places like Sona Road, where there is lots of commercial development, as a result, there is a lot of residential development as well. So you will be able to pick up something. I think there are a few which are available in 90 lakh to 1 crore because the markets have been flat and it continues to remain flat. However, there's a very steady rental demand in this market because it is close to the commercial areas and it also has good social infrastructure. It has schools, hospitals, retail, everything is around in Sona Road. So it's got good rental returns. So I think this is one of the things that you should be looking at. And if it's going to give you a steady return, I suppose that should help you.
Right. So that is the choice that you should make. We have Gautam now who's called in from Bengaluru. Gautam, how can we help you? What's your question?
Hey, this is Gautam here. So I got LGCL Pueblo, which is in Bangalore, Hosa Road. So I bought in 2014. Mm-hmm. So early 2014. So I just wanted to know what is the future prospect and, how long should I hold this? I want to stay, but, I just want to know. Really, what's the prospect of this?
Okay, let me just get this checked with you again. Let me just get this right. 2014, you bought this Hosa Road, you said, right?
That's correct.
Right. So he's bought a property in Hosa Road in Bengaluru 2 years back. How long should he hold on to it?
So let's depends on how long.
Yes, Gautam.
So it depends on, how long this is going to be... give me a good return so I can hold for 5 years.
Okay, he wants to know how long should he hold on so that he gets a good return.
I would say 5 years is a reasonable time. You should be able to get good returns. Property markets are not investable for less than 5 years. Around 5 years, you should check out the local market conditions at that point of time. You should be able to get at least a 20-25% rise because these are early stage developments, if I'm not mistaken. It's off Sarjapur Road, so you do get a lot of demand from the IT areas. And I think this property is going to be completed by about December, later this year. So I think this is a good project for you to hold on to. And once the property is handed over, you will see the values start to rise. It normally takes at least a year to year and a half for the values to come back to a rational rate. after which you will see a period of stable values, and that is the time you get very good rental values. As occupancy goes up and as the demand goes up, that is when you will be able to get good returns. But remember, this is a luxury project, and one of the things that you have to keep in mind is that the Bangalore market, luxury has been performing very slow, and luxury is also oversupplied in the market. So it's not that you'll be able to exit very easily. You'll have to wait and check out the market conditions at that point of time.
You know, Jayashree, like you said, 5 years is the basic minimum that one needs to hold property to actually see some kind of appreciation. Now, Gautam had a very good question there. How long do I wait for good returns? Now, I'm adding to that question, what is good returns in a property? If I buy property today and I'm willing to hold it for 5 years or 7 years, when do I know that, you know, I've probably got good returns and this is the time when I should actually look at selling and exiting that particular property?
Kavita, if you're buying into early stage markets, that at that stage you're entering at a very low base, and you will know that those are the markets where you can expect a much larger rate of return. Similarly, if you buy a small property, you can get better, rate of return is much higher because it's a small investment and it's easy to exit. When you're buying a premium property, you're spending a lot in the beginning, and these are luxury villas, very few, 50, 55 luxury villas. So here, the wait time to sell your property will be a little more. It will be more difficult to sell because luxury properties don't move as fast as smaller or mid ranges of properties. But you will be able to get, I would say, a 20-25% return over 5-7 years. That should be a good return. But can anybody tell you today when you should exit? I don't think so. I mean, you don't have crystal balls, right? You'll have to play according to local market conditions.
No, I understand that. What I wanted to know is the basic minimum return that one should be expecting from property, and after which one can probably sit down and then take a call whether or not to exit that property. And like you said, it's around 25%. So over a period of, say, 5 or 7 years, if my property is appreciated by 20-25%, I can actually look at exiting that. That's what you're saying, right?
At one time, I used to say your property value will double in 5 years. Not anymore. It doesn't.
We are no longer in that kind of market. But yes, 20-25% can be considered a decent return in real estate currently. So if you have property that you're investing in, hold on for at least 5 to 7 years. That's a basic minimum. Expect at least 20-25% appreciation over the capital value. That is how much you've paid for the property. Once you get that kind of return, then you can actually think of exiting that particular property. Moving on, we have Edward Salins who's called in. How can we help you? Edward?
Hello, yes?
Yes, Edward, how can we help you?
Hello?
Edward, we can hear you. What's your question?
No, my question is that I have a property at Binder.
Okay.
Binder East. And I want to sell it off.
Okay.
And I would like to know how much I should get out of it. 730 square feet.
730 square feet. And yes, when did you buy this?
I bought it in 2005.
2005. Okay.
It is 10 to 12 years old.
And where is it located in Binder East?
In Binder East, it's a place called Golden Nest.
Golden Nest.
Yeah, Golden Nest Phase 1.
Okay, Golden Nest Phase 1. 10 to 12 year old property. He bought it in 2005. Actually, it's more than that. 10 to 12 years actually, 730 square feet. What kind of price can you really expect for this?
Going by what's the listed values on the site, I think you should be able to get about 55 to 65 lakh for that property. How much did he buy it for?
Edward, I hope you're still on the phone line. How much did you buy this for?
No, when I bought it in 2005, that time it cost me around about 7 lakhs.
7 lakhs. So you've already, your property is currently priced at around 55 to 65 lakh rupees. That's the range that we are giving you. Your property prices should fall somewhere in between that. So yes, I think it's time for you to exit. What do you say, Jayashree? Should he hold on or should he exit?
No, exit. It's 12 years old. A property that, up to about 7, 8 to 10 years, the property is an appreciating asset. After that, you have to put significant inputs in terms of re-engineering, making sure that you're rewiring the property and so on, if you want it to maintain its values. So I would say 12 years is a good time. You've held on to the property. You've got good returns. This is a good time for you to consider exiting. You've got good returns, really good returns. If you take the same money and you reinvest it in places like, say, Badlapur East, Ambernath, you would be able to get up to about 900 square feet in Ambernath and about 850 to 1200 square feet in Badlapur. But these are developments by local developers. So check out the legality of the title, check out the approvals, and see that they have not overbuilt. They've stuck to whatever has been sanctioned. If you buy those properties, it's a good enough reinvestment. And these are areas that are expected to do better over a period of time.
Okay, so Edward, you can look at Ambernath and Badlapur if you're looking to reinvest the gains from selling that particular property. Both of them are priced, look at that. Ambernath is priced 3,884 rupees per square foot. Badlapur at 3,694 rupees per square foot. Clearly, you bought it at Bhayandar at a time when... It must have been priced lower than this, much, much lower than this. And you've seen the gains that you can get from holding on to property for 10 to 12 years. You can look at the Ambernath and Badlapur markets. You may not get such stupendous returns, but you should get decent, steady returns over there as well, because these are emerging markets. Clocked a 13% return. That's the Ambernath market for you over the last 2 years. This is when markets are largely stable in the rest of the country. Badlapur chart will be up in a bit and we'll be able to tell you, there it is. That market has also shown 10% returns in the last 2 years. But do remember that both of these markets are largely driven by people who come and work in South Mumbai. So it's advisable to look for property near the railway station or with easy access to the railway stations. Moving on, Mrs. Raman has written in on email and wants to know the approximate resale value of a 3BHK flat at Vasant Kunj Sector A, Pocket C in New Delhi. Please tell me what kind of growth can I expect in this location in the next few years. Jayashree, that's in your backyard. What would you say?
Vasant Kunj has already seen, it's a I think almost 15-20 year old development by the DDA, and you have seen a lot of appreciation currently between 1.5 to 2.3 crore. That is what these properties cost, and you will see that there are blocks A, B, C, D. D, I think, has a slightly lower listed value. C has one of the highest, and I think Mrs. Raman is looking for pocket C. So she shouldn't be able to, she shouldn't have a problem selling off the property. I don't think you need to hold it any longer if you're looking at it from an investment point of view, because it's already reached its value. You must have bought it at some 20, 25 lakhs, and today you're getting roughly 2.5 crore. And it has remained in this range for a while. So I think it's more or less plateaued in Vasant Kunj.
Okay, but Jayashree, staying with the Delhi market per se, because most of the questions that we get on the show is about the larger NCR market. People are looking to buy Noida, Noida Extension, Gurgaon, etc. Now, within Delhi, if you are looking to buy property, again, I'm talking middle income housing, what is the kind of budgets that you should be working with? Which are the locations that you can actually look at?
A lot of demand is there for South Delhi properties, and South Delhi properties are of two types. The DDA colonies, DDA stopped making new properties in South Delhi, I think about 10-12 years ago. So these are all older properties which have to be refurbished before you buy, before you can use it. So you will get it for anything between 70 lakh to about 2.5 crore. But if you're looking at older colonies like Panchsheel Park, Safdarjung Enclave, and so on. These are plotted developments, areas where there was plotted developments which were in the 70s, 80s, and so on. These are being redeveloped by a lot of small builders. And here you get a lot of new developments, new floors, the single floors that you get in South Delhi. And you will get these at much higher rates because they are new, they are modern, they're reconstructed, the old structures have been torn down, and it is being redone. Now, Kavita, one thing you should remember is that the government is trying to seed redevelopment in Delhi, especially South Delhi. They've used Kidwainagar as their first point, where they have picked up their own colony and redeveloped it completely so that the place will have a brand new look in maybe another year or so. They've also announced that all the government colonies are going to be redeveloped again. So you are going to see a lot of planned redevelopment in Delhi, especially South Delhi. And this will probably move to the DDA colonies as well, if once they get their format right. In other parts of Delhi, the most demanded areas are West Delhi, especially smaller units like Janakpuri, Vikaspuri, and so on. And you also see a lot of this kind of demand in places like Rohini and Pitampura, which are again DDA colonies. And in, some of them are plotted developments as well.
Right. So even if, you know, the land pooling still gets delayed and for whatever reason it gets held over, that is a story that we are tracking very avidly on Magic Bricks now. But even if that gets delayed for some more time, redevelopment will probably see a fresh supply coming into the Delhi market, which frankly, like Jayashree has been telling you, is right now has a lot of old supply that is available, resales that are coming out, but not too much of fresh supply. But fresh supply is coming in through redevelopment. So we'll have to wait and watch for that. Another email query now that's coming in from Ankur. Ankur owns a flat in Yashwant Nagar, Virar West. Now he wants to relocate to Malad East and wants to know what the current rates are and future prospects are for both these markets. Jayashree?
Kavita, you'll have to put it up on the screen for me. I think if you want to exit the Virar market, like last time I think I was talking about the Vasai market, I think these are markets which have achieved their potential. And if you do want to exit these markets, it's a good time to exit because they have, you know, you saw a dip in the market and you've seen seen them rising somewhat. So this is a good time to exit Virar, Vasai and so on. Now, he wants to buy in the Malad market, right? In Malad, you will need about 13,000-14,000 per square foot. This is the value that you need. And you, one thing we have seen is that there is both Malad East and West, there is plenty of supply in the market. So I think this is a good time for you to go and check out the these markets and exit Vasai and move to Malad.
Exit Virar and move to Malad. Exit Virar and move to Malad is what Jayashree tells you. But do keep in mind, Ankur, that while the Virar market is priced at around 4,000 or 500 rupees odd per square foot, the Malad East market is priced at around 14,000 rupees per square foot. So that's a difference that you will need to factor in when you are looking to invest in Malad. Right. Lots of people looking to buy into the real estate market, lots of people looking to upgrade. But for us, it's time up on today's episode of Property Hotline. Jayashree Kurup, thank you very much for joining us. And if you have any questions related to real estate, it could be buying, selling, investing, it could be legal queries, it could be taxes related to real estate, it could be home finance. Get in touch with us. IDs flashing on your screens. We'll get the country's top experts to answer each and every one of them. That's a promise. Thank you very much for tuning in. Keep watching Magic Bricks now.
You can watch live TV on our website, mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at Magic Bricks Now. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.